Today we will perform the next practical to determine the surface tension of given liquid by using drop count method by using stalagmometer. Okay, so here we can calculate the surface tension. Surface tension means the tension which creates on the surface of any liquids. Okay, so surface tension we have to calculate by using here drop count method. For drop count purpose we can take a four solvents, that is the water solvent, ethanol, acetone and benzene. Okay, first we have to take a water solvents. We can take a water solvents in a beaker and then we have to use a stalagmometer, and in the stalagmometer we can feel the stalagmometer by using water solvent or by using bulb. Okay, when the stalagmometer is filled of water solvent, then stalagmometer by using water solvent, then here see here the stalagmometer, this is the mark A and this is the below mark B. So we can attach this stalagmometer to this stand in vertical position, and then we can release the slowly water solvent, and we have to count the water number of water drops when the water fall from the A mark to the B mark. Okay, then we can start the counting of the water number drops. After counting the water solvent, number of water solvents, then again water solvent we can fill in the stalagmometers, and again counting the number of drops. Okay, up to mark A to B. Means water fall from mark A to B, then that number of how much number of drops is created in this water solvents we can count. Okay, and this procedure is repeated for water solvent 3 times. Okay, after 3 times this procedure is repeated, then we have to take a second solvent, that is the benzene. Benzene, it is a volatile, so we have to pack or we have to keep close by using. Then fill the benzene solvent in the stalagmometer slowly. By using rubber bulb, we can fill the benzene solvent slowly. In this stalagmometer, so here benzene is slowly filling in the stalagmometer by using rubber bulb. When the rubber bulb releases their pressure, benzene solvent rises up in the stalagmometer. We can filling the benzene up to the mark A. Okay, then we can remove the rubber bulb. Benzene is filling completely in the stalagmometer, and we have to count the number of drops of benzene from mark A to the mark B. Okay, put the stalagmometer in a vertical position constantly and then release the pressure. Then slowly benzene drops is counted. Okay, benzene number of drops we have to count. Then again we can fill this stalagmometer second time up to the mark A, and then up to the mark A to B, when benzene is fall slowly we can count the number of drops. second time. Then same procedure we can repeat again third times. Okay. After the three times we have to count the number of benzene drops from mark A to B. Then we have to take a third solvent, that is the acetone. Okay. Acetone, it is also volatile. So it is easily evaporates. We can feel the acetone in the stalagmometer like same manner benzene solvents. Up to the mark A, we can feel the acetone. See here, acetone is filled completely in the stalagmometer. Then we can attach this stalagmometer to the vertical position in a vertical position to the stand. Then we have to release the slowly pressure, and then again we can count the number of drops of acetone solvents. Okay. From solvent is fall from mark A to the B, then those all, when the solvent is reaches to the mark A to the B, then that number of solvents creating the drops, and that drops we have to count. Okay. And same this procedure again we can repeat the three times. After the counting the number of drops, then we can calculate the surface tension by using calculations. See here, for calculation of surface tension or for determination of surface tension of any solvent, we can use this formula. Okay, gamma 1 is equal to n2 rho 1 divided by n1 rho 2 multiplied by surface tension 2 gamma 2. Gamma 1 means it is the surface tension of test liquid. Test liquid means here we have to use a four liquids, water solvents, then acetone, ethanol, benzene. Okay. Then gamma 2 means the surface tension of water. It is the standard or reference solvents. Okay, we have to use. That is the surface tension of water is 72.8 dyne per centimeter. So we can use this surface tension value in this formula as it is. That is the 72.8 dyne per centimeter. Then rho 1 and rho 2, it is the density. Rho 1 and rho 2 density of test liquid and water liquid. N 1 means it is the number of drops of test liquid. That is the ethanol, acetone and benzene number of drops, N1. N2 means it is the number of drops of water solvents. Okay. So by using this formula we can calculate the surface tension. For before calculation of surface tension we have to calculate the density. For calculation of density, density is equals to mass upon volume. So calculation of density of all solvents, we have to use a specific gravity bottle. We can take an empty specific gravity bottle and we can weigh the empty specific gravity bottle. So W1, it is the weight of specific gravity bottle, or it is the empty specific gravity bottle weight, that is the W1. Then W2, in that specific gravity bottle we have to fill the solvents, water solvents, then ethanol, then benzene and then acetone. After filling the specific gravity bottle with water solvents, then we can weigh that specific gravity bottle again. So we have to W1 and W2 is find out. Then we can calculate the weight of that solvent. For calculation of weight, we can W2 is minus to the W1, means weight of gravity bottle plus weight of water is minus to the weight of gravity bottle. Then we have to find out the weight of water or weight of any solvents. That is the W is equals to W2 minus W1. That is the, we have to find out easily weight. Then for calculation of density, density is equals to mass upon volume. The mass of solvent is calculated here, and that mass we have to write as it is. Okay. And volume of solvents means we have to take a volume of solvent in the specific gravity bottle. So the specific gravity bottle volume is 25 ml. So we can write here 25 ml, and then by using these two values we can calculate the density of any solvents. We can calculate the density of water, density of ethanol, benzene and acetone. Okay, after calculating the density part, then see here in this chart we can take our liquids, first water, ethanol, acetone and benzene. This is the test liquids, ethanol, acetone and benzene. Water is the reference liquid or reference, standard reference. Okay, so number of drops of water we have to count 3 times, and then we can write here. Then we have to take the ethanol in the sphygmomanometer and then again count the number of drops up to the mark A to the B. Okay, solution reaches mark A to B. Then ethanol number of drops is here, then acetone number of drops is here and benzene number of drops is here. Okay, so in these three solvents, acetone showing the maximum number of drops as compared to the ethanol and benzene. So the maximum number of drops of acetone, so their surface tension is also less. If the number of drops is maximum, means your solution or your solvent is fastly removing from the sphygmomanometer, means their surface tension is very low. Due to the surface tension is low, their number of drops is fastly removing from the sphygmomanometer. Okay, so after we have to write down the number of drops, then we can calculate the mean value of number of drops. We have to add these three number of drops divided by 3, then it is the mean number of drops of water. Then 74, it is the mean number of drops of water, mean number of drops of ethanol. Then like the acetone number of mean value is 98 and benzene 75. By using this number of drops and density value, we can calculate the density of water, ethanol, acetone and benzene. By using density value and number of drops, we have to calculate the surface tension. Okay, so see here in the surface tension formula, N2 is the number of drops of water. Number of drops of water is the 26. So you can write here 26. Rho 1 means density of test liquid. So density of test liquid is the 1.06. Okay, for calculation of ethanol surface tension, because water surface tension is the 72.8. It is the standard or reference solvents. So hence we can write the here surface tension of water is as it is. Okay, but we can calculate the surface tension of ethanol, acetone and benzene. So for calculation of ethanol surface tension, we can write down here N2 is the number of drops of water, that is the 26. Rho 1 is the density of solvents, ethanol density solvents, that is the 0.866 upon N1 is the number of drops of test liquid, ethanol number of drops. Here we have to write 74 is the N1. Okay, then rho 2 means the density of water, and the density of water is the 1.06 into gamma 2. Gamma 2 means it is the surface tension of reference liquid. Okay, that is the surface tension of water, and the surface tension of water is 72.8. When we can put the all value in this formula, we can calculate the gamma 1, and gamma 1 means it is the surface tension of test liquid, that is the surface tension of ethanol. Like the same manner, you have to calculate the surface tension of acetone and benzene by using this formula. See here, in this formula, all the 2 indicates the reference liquid, means N2, Rho 2 or Gamma 2. This all indicates the water solvents or reference solvents. And N1, Rho 1 and Gamma 1 indicates the test liquid, okay? Then by using this formula, you have to calculate the surface tension. So see here the result, water surface tension, that is the 72.8 dyne per centimeter. Then ethanol surface tension 20.85 dyne per centimeter, acetone 15.35 and benzene 28. Okay. So see here the surface tension value. In this surface tension value, the maximum surface tension is appear, that is the benzene 21.28. Why the maximum surface tension is appear in the benzene? Because, maximum surface tension is the water, but we have to remove the water, and when we get comparing the ethanol, acetone and benzene, in these three solvents, the maximum surface tension is the benzene, because the benzene showing the less number of drops as compared to the acetone and ethanol. Okay, so according to the number of drops, your surface tension value is depends. If your number of drops is very high, then your surface tension is very low. But if your number of drops is very low, then your surface tension value is also low. सबसे लो वैल्यू यहाँ पे इथेनॉल के नंबर ऑफ ड्रॉप्स की, सो सबसे लो सरफेस टेंशन भी इथेनॉल का है. ओके, देन सबसे मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ नंबर ऑफ ड्रॉप्स ऑफ एसीटोन है, इसलिए सबसे लो सरफेस टेंशन ये एसीटोन का है. ओके, मीन्स नंबर ऑफ ड्रॉप्स मोर देन सरफेस टेंशन वैल्यू लेस, एंड नंबर ऑफ ड्रॉप्स इज लेस देन सरफेस टेंशन वैल्यू इज हाई. ओके,